Going on, guys. I'm Steve. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. If it's your first time stopping by the channel, hit that subscribe button. Trust me, you won't regret it. You're a returning subscriber as always, guys. Welcome back, and I do appreciate the support. Guys, we got some news out of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Shout out Milwaukee. As far as the case of Sade Robinson, 19-year-old lady that was found, well, parts of her, no disrespect, were found, and as people still look for the rest of her body, this woman, Miss Robinson, went out on a date with this man who's currently locked up, Maxwell Anderson, a 33-year-old man. This guy right here was the last person to see her alive. Supposedly went out on a date. That was the last time anybody heard of her, heard from her, until parts of her body's been washing up from Lake Michigan, and other parts of her body were found elsewhere. This guy went out on a date with her, set her car on fire. Her body then disappeared. He's locked up, jumped on the bus like nothing happened. After he disposed of the vehicle, everything leads to him. This guy today, ladies and gentlemen, made an appearance in court. And guess what? He's sticking to his gun, saying he didn't do it. And he's going to trial, which I think is a stupid idea. But I mean, he's going to get smoked regardless. This is what happened in court today. We'll come back and talk a little bit about it. Unfortunate situation. And like I said, my prayers go out to the family. This dude right here going to burn. Watch. Check it out.
Our big story today at 5, the man accused of killing a Milwaukee woman and dismembering her body pleads not guilty.
Prosecutors say Maxwell Anderson killed Sade Robinson and then mutilated her body earlier this month. Aaron Maben is live with more from today's hearing. Aaron.
Ted and Mary, this was a quick, straightforward preliminary hearing. It lasted just 4 minutes. One of the big takeaways is Maxwell Anderson will head to trial for the killing of Sade Robinson. This is a gruesome, complex case that began with a first date that somehow went horribly wrong.
Accused killer Maxwell Anderson walked into a Milwaukee County courtroom for a preliminary hearing Monday afternoon. Prosecutors say he killed Sade Robinson before dismembering the 19-year-old's body earlier this month.
I have read the criminal complaint. It does state probable cause. Waive reading?
We do.
The 33-year-old waived his right to a preliminary hearing and will head to trial.
Did you also understand that by waiving that hearing, you are conceding that the state can establish probable cause and you will be ordered to stand trial?
Yes, Your Honor.
Anyone make any promises to get you to give up your hearing?
No, Your Honor.
This is Maxwell Anderson's first court appearance since the torso and arm believed to belong to Sade Robinson were found along Lake Michigan last week. Anderson was arrested April 4th. 2 days after someone found Robinson's leg at Warnemont Park in Cudahy. A criminal complaint says investigators used surveillance and cell phone data to track Anderson down. Prosecutors say the two went on a first date when Robinson was killed. What led to the death and a motive are not clear.
This gentleman, I believe, moved very calculated through the city and was intentional about where he placed the body parts, the car, setting it on fire, and just getting on the bus as if it was just an ordinary day.
April Bentley was one of several people who attended the hearing to support Sade Robinson's family.
I needed to be here to support the family, even though they weren't here. I stand in the gap.
Earlier today, we got our hands on a brand new amended criminal complaint that reveals the blood that was swabbed on the bedding in the basement of Maxwell Anderson's home is not a match for Sade Robinson's DNA, but prosecutors did not say whose blood that is. Maxwell Anderson's next court appearance will be May 16th.
Gentlemen, that's what happened in court today. That says his next court date is May 16th. He's waived his preliminary trial hearing, well, his preliminary hearing. Basically, I have nothing to say. Nobody coerced me into saying what I'm going to say in court. We're running this to trial. I'm sticking to my guns. I think that's a bad idea for this guy. It is. Now, they supposedly found blood in a mattress in his home. I don't know if a lot of you guys know that. They did a DNA matchup. That blood does not match up with Sade Robinson's DNA. So that makes me think, like a lot of you guys said, there may be more victims. This guy comes off as a sadomasochist to me. Maybe he was messing with Sade. Things got a little bit rough. That ain't his her style. She wanted out, and it ended badly. But either way, man, she's gone, and it's upsetting. This man is 19. She's 19 years old. He's 33. I still can't get over that in my head, what the connection was with him and her. Seriously, I mean, at 33 years old, I never looked at a girl with teen at the end of her age. I never looked at a 20-year-old. See, the thing is, like, you know, as life progresses, you remember where you were and how you thought at a certain age. And a lot of us don't want to go back to that age. So him messing with this girl makes me believe this was targeted. Maybe he went in and out of that place. He seen her. You know, like a lot of these people that kill people, they target certain type of people. Might have been a certain color, you know, of her skin. May have been a certain way she wore her hair. You never know. You don't know. I mean, but it's something that drew him to her to do what he did. Think about that. They still talk about, we don't have no motive. This guy is not talking. He has a vow of silence. He ain't gonna never talk. You'll never find this motive out. That's why he wants to go straight to trial. He don't want no prelim. He don't want everything shown to people. He want to go right to trial. Boom, this is what we got. And he'll rest with that. Like I said, it's a bad idea. They got him in every place, right, that he was with the girl, Miss Robinson. Text message saying he picked her up. Now, all of a sudden, your main defense is this. You don't have no proof of that. Well, she was with you last. Yeah, but I didn't do it. Makes no sense. How many people that go on a date, you ladies out there, soon as you get done with the date, you do what? You call a friend, you call somebody and tell them about the date or any juicy details. None of this fits the situation. Girl just up and vanished like smoke after she was with you. And they know she was with you. Because all of the places that the cell phone ping, how'd the car get burned up? If she got out the car with you, who did she get in the car with? It's so many different things that make him look stupid. Then he got that freak dungeon in his damn thing. That other girl, I'm sure she going to come out. The prosecutor going to get a hold of her, have her come in there and talk. And I guarantee you, as this thing drags on, more and more women might come forward and say, you know what? This guy right here did this, did that. His character's already mugged. You know how it is with these, with the justice. They try to paint you as a certain person, and he can't look no uglier than he is now. He can't. Man, the family didn't even show up. And I don't know if I don't blame him or not. And the reason why is, man, when somebody does this something this cruel to a family member and you can't get your hands on them, a lot of times it hurts you just sitting there and listening to him talk about or have them offer him, you know, certain rights for him to defend himself when everybody know this guy right here has something to do with it, if not doing it himself, which I think. Like I said before, man, a lot of people are still losing sleep. Every time you see that man take a breath and you think that Sade Robinson, your relative, is not doing that, does something to you, especially as a man. Can we think like that? So this next court date is May 16th. Depending on the trial and when this does, if this doesn't run with the Tyree Nichols case, I'm going to try to get down there and check this out. I think that'd be cool to report to you guys live from the courtroom, or, you know, after the courtroom, like the regular media does. I think it would be cool. So let's just stay tuned and see when these times run up, and I'll start keeping contact with certain people I have out there in Wisconsin that I met as recently about this case, and I'll have some updates for you. But like I said, may she rest in peace, man. Family gets some type of relief that he's locked up at least, but this guy is going to trial. He's an idiot. I don't know if Dave is probably offering the death penalty. He's trying to go to trial to see if he can get out of that. But either way, he do not deserve life in jail if he is the person that did it. For some reason, he acting like he not. And I find that hard to believe. I'll see you in the next video. Take care.